Now to more coverage of the approach of Hurricane Matthew. A lot of people are keeping a close eye on the Category 4 monster. Now, earlier in our newscast, we showed you video of the storm in coastal Colombia with winds over 100 miles per hour. Matthew has washed away homes, roads, and bridges. People in Jamaica and Haiti are taking cover right now. Forecasters expect more than 20 inches of rain to pound the islands. If you are planning to travel to the Caribbean, and that includes any cruises, be sure to double check with your carrier.
Now, your Super Doppler 10 forecast with meteorologist Jeremy Wheeler.
I thought I'd show a couple of different things this time, and we've got the upper level winds in here, and so you can tell by these upper level winds, they're coming up out of the south. That's what's lifting this storm northward very subtly. It's moving north only at 4 miles an hour, but there it is. There's the center of it. There's the island of Jamaica, and so this is on a northward motion. So these upper level winds will carry this northward over the next 24 to 48 hours, and that's why the forecast takes it north too. It's upgraded, moving north at 6 miles an hour, pardon me, for the winds, the motion. Winds sustained 130 miles an hour around that center, and it's a Category 4 hurricane. Looks like it's going to remain a Category 4 as it heads towards either eastern Cuba, western Haiti, or both. And so this is bad news for that region, the entire region. It's a very large storm. That's the center. Remember, the center wraps and stretches out pretty far away, hundreds of miles away. So they're going to feel the impact. Now, this will get in towards the Bahamas as we get into Thursday as a Category 3 hurricane. This is the latest official forecast. There's a pretty high confidence in it taking this track at that point. Now, after that point, it becomes more uncertain. The area, the possible path grows quite a bit. And so into Friday and Saturday morning, Category 2 hurricane now going a little bit more to the north-northeast. And so now southern parts of North Carolina and South Carolina are in the possible path. And most likely it would try and move off to the northeast here and head a little closer to our region. So let's look at the computer models. There's a lot of them. Each one is a different track. Each one's a different model. And so you can tell, well, the bulk of them take it in very close to Hatteras. A couple of them even take it inland a little bit. And I won't say any of these are favored in here, but there's kind of a clustering. And so, you know, some of these models that are offshore, especially that CMC, that one does not favor. That one does not do a good job. So I do show it, though, just for an added reference. Now, here's a couple models which have been doing a good job so far this year with other systems. One's the GFS, which is the American model. One's European. So what do these do? Well, they take it north and then into the Bahamas. Up to Thursday, there's some pretty good agreement. But then around Friday, they start to split. Whereas the GFS brings it right here along the coast, but the European keeps it to the south for a while and then takes it out to sea, and that would be a pretty good scenario for us compared to the other one. So hopefully it will take that track, the European. At this time, here's what you want to do. You want to check your hurricane kits if you're in Hampton Roads, just to make sure that everything's in there and proper and okay. If you're along the Outer Banks, especially on the south end, you want to start to prepare those kits because you're probably going to feel some effects even if it is offshore. Outer Banks, you're probably going to see some moderate tidal flooding out of this. Even if it moves, you know, offshore, if it moves as close as some of these models show, you're going to get major tidal flooding out of this. So be prepared for this later this week. Hopefully the track changes. There's still time for this to change. But again, even if it's offshore, there's going to be some impacts down there. Wind forecast, very track dependent. Stay tuned for updates to that right now. That's pretty uncertain. But I think the tidal flooding is going to come up because it's going to be a big system. And even if it's to our south, it's going to push some water our way. All right, so locally right now we got high pressure. We have a northeast wind. Things pretty quiet for us right now. We still have a little bit of moisture in place, so there might be a stray shower today. I think our model's really overdoing it, though, for the coverage. So, again, just a stray shower, too, in the region, and that's about it. So here we go, 3 p.m., maybe a stray shower. I'm calling for partly cloudy skies for 90% of the area, 90% of the day. So, yeah, 10% chance of seeing a stray shower. Overnight, quiet, partly cloudy, maybe a stray shower there. And then tomorrow, partly cloudy skies, maybe mostly sunny at times. I think we're going to be looking pretty good with that high in place. So today, our temperatures there in the 60s right now. We're going to see high temperatures, mostly in the upper 70s, a few 80s south and inland. Again, partly cloudy. There might be that stray shower, but a very low chance. And there's your boating forecast. We got northeast winds, 8 to 12 knots, seas 2 to 3 feet. There's a small craft advisory on the ocean, but not on the bay. There's your 7-day forecast. Pretty quiet weather next couple of days. We might see some minor tidal flooding around Wednesday just because of the northeast winds that we have, not because of the hurricane. And so as we get into, you know, Friday, well, we're already going to have the tide up a little bit. So Hampton Roads could see at least some minor tidal flooding Wednesday through Friday. And again, the Outer Banks, things will get pretty rough down there. So stay tuned, everybody, but especially the Outer Banks.